2012 set us back 100 years and the rules have changed. Things you cannot do while black, one. Don't ever walk in white neighborhoods. Stay in your own. It's for the best. Be diminutive, they already see you as too brimming. Never wear black hoodies. Trayvon Martin, two. Don't sell cigarettes. It's your fault for making a profit. They don't care if you can't breathe, but when your six children inhale, they'll take in the last breath you are given. Eric Garner, three. God forbid you have a son who likes toy guns and playgrounds. He'll be a threat, you see. He's a thug. Tell him to hush his black down. Tamir Rice, four. Never question your rights. Always obey him. He's just doing his job. Be submissive. Let him beat you. Do not fight. You obviously committed suicide. You were probably just another angry black woman anyway. Sandra Blay, I'm five. Do not withdraw money from the ATM. Do not pass go. Go to jail. Never hold the door open for a white woman and her baby. Don't be with your black friends. You're too much of a threat. All you people do is steal. Jason Goolsby, six. Never be diagnosed with bipolar disorder. Just another reason for them to lock you up, tie your wrists down, beat you, tase you, and torture you like racism did. You're just another black in their jail cell. Matthew Ajibade, seven. Never let your seven-year-old daughter sleep alone. The stars will never watch over her, and she will wonder why her hair is just as booming. Your house just might get raided. She should have kept her hair tamed. Ayanna Jones, eight. I won't tell you again. Never be in public with your black friends. Don't shout. Your skin is just as odd as your voice is, and apparently phones look like guns now, so do not carry one. Rakia Boyd, nine. Don't be in a wheelchair. Run. Run from the superior shot and the adversary cop. They fired 10 bullets at you. When your body jumped out of your wheelchair like rain, it was just a 4-minute-long video, but 28 years of your life went missing. Jeremy McDowell, 10. Black bodies are getting scratched off like sevens on scratch tickets. 2015 was never a lucky year for us. You remember Sam Dubose, Ezra Ford, Walter Scott. You remember Anthony Hill, Christian Taylor, Fred Hampton, Mario Woods. You remember Sheena Proctor, Corey Jones, Aquan McDonald. Do you remember me? I'm not dead yet, but parts of me are. Do you see my body? Laid on this ground like I'm almost worth something. Tell CNN if they're gonna pay me as a thug, let the canvas be the handcuffs. Let the bullet be nameless but not colorblind. The bullet that tap dance in my spine that I hunched over to make him feel safer. Too bad I can't hunch my skin though, right? My body was just another gold star added to the constellation. I don't want to be shot today. I don't want to be another hashtag for those who cannot attend my funeral. I don't want to be another Twitter activist today. Too many hashtags roll off our tongues as if blood has been there before. Do not swallow our anguish. I heard a man is only as good as his words. Michael Brown put his hands up, said, don't shoot. They thought he was only as half as good as his words. I heard we are born with our hands up. I heard this melanin, this body is my protest. To be black and to be alive is to succumb to a man in blue. To know your blood will always be on these streets. To come home before the police lights come on. To leave all that hurt in our pockets and to march like it's Bloody Sunday again. So when you ask me, what's it like to be black? I will tell you. I will tell you.
All right. I will give you 3, 2, 1. Raise them up, raise them up, raise them up, up, up. Okay, I have a 9.6. An 8.6, a 9.2, a 9.1, and a 9.3. Please applaud that poem. We good, we good, we good. All right, get excited.